Today, I will be showing you the top 10 kidney killer bad habits that most people keep doing every single day without even noticing because they are unaware of long-term and even fatal damage these bad habits are doing to their kidneys. There's one thing that can help you avoiding these kidney killer bad habits: knowing what they are. Hello, this is Catherine. Welcome to 00 Kidney. The top 10 of bad habits for kidney health I'll show you today are not just to be avoided by kidney disease patients. Even if you are healthy, they will still damage your kidneys. These vices have serious long-term consequences that are putting your kidneys in constant overdrive and are overwhelming them with dangerous poisons and toxins. Stopping them is a great way of improving your kidney function and avoiding health problems. Let's see what they are. Number 10, eating too many salads. Many people think that eating a salad is the low calorie, healthy option. It can be, if you do it right. But most get excited by the mixings or maybe like dressings more than veggies and end up creating a salad that will be more calorically dense than a sandwich. Yes, the veggies in the salad are healthy, but the excessive dressings definitely aren't. So before you give yourself a pat on the back for eating a salad for lunch, also consider this. Most dressings are too rich in salt for any healthy diet, and your kidneys absolutely don't like too much salt. Not to mention the lack of nutritional value and the content of sugars and trans fats. And fat-free dressings aren't exactly healthy for the kidneys either. They can be packed with additives and sugar, poison for your kidneys. Fancy a salad? Avoid dressings and excess sodium. Squeeze some lemon juice on your salad instead, along with olive oil and a splash of vinegar. To season things up, use fresh herbs and dried spices like red pepper flakes, oregano, and freshly ground pepper. Number 9, smoking. Smoking won't just cause over 10 types of cancer, stroke, heart disease, diabetes, blindness, birth defects during pregnancy in women, and impotence in men. It will also seriously damage your kidneys. This is what researchers were able to prove after decades of studies. Smoking is the biggest preventable cause of death in the world, and it does not just damage your lungs. It can slow down the blood flow to several organs, including the kidneys, causing both short and long-term damage. Smoking also causes high blood pressure, the second leading cause of chronic kidney disease. This is basically like saying that smoking directly causes chronic kidney disease. The problem with smoking is that it's actually not just a bad habit, it's a true addiction, studies say. This means that quitting is a lot harder than some people think, and smokers know this very well. The road to quit is a tough one, and lapses are unfortunately common. But why is this so low on this top 10 then? Okay, never mind, worse bad habits are coming ahead. The one bit of good news is that people who quit smoking have been observed to have fewer kidney abnormalities than current smokers. And this is just one more reason to quit smoking. Number 8. Living in the city. Today, more people than ever live in urban environments where dirty air, stress, and lack of natural landscapes are a bigger threat to our health than it may seem. Breathing polluted air won't just put your lungs and throat at risk. The poisons present in the air can do serious damage to the cardiovascular system too. And just like for cigarette smoking, whenever the cardiovascular system starts to take damage, the kidneys will suffer the same damage. They're connected. Kidneys and heart are part of the same system. Also, when we talk about living in a polluted environment, the poisons present in the air are not the only risk for our kidneys. We also need to factor in the risks caused by the stress. Overpopulated cities are a big source of stress for your body. And stress causes hypertension, the second leading cause of CKD. It's no wonder that people living in very populated areas are more at risk for kidney disease than those living in more green and natural parts of the world. Number 7. Not getting checked. Especially if we're talking about kidney health, waiting for the symptoms to show up before scheduling an appointment with the doctor can be an extremely dangerous bad habit. Kidney disease is called the silent killer for a good reason. The kidneys are a redundant system, meaning that they can get their job done even with just 40 or 50% of their capability of filtering the blood. But if kidney function went down to 40% without you noticing, it means that there is a very serious underlying problem causing damage. And this also means that this condition can eventually lead to kidney failure, dialysis, or even death. Yes, there are people out there with seriously compromised kidneys that don't even know they have a problem. A really impressive number of people actually, if we take a look at the statistics. Chronic kidney disease affects 1 in 7 adults in the US. We're talking about 37 million people just in the US. Now, the even scarier number is that 90% of the people with chronic kidney disease don't know they have it. To make things even worse, approximately 80 million people in the US is at risk for CKD. I know that these numbers are so big that our minds have trouble understanding them, but we're talking about 1 in 3 American adults here. So don't wait to see the foam in the urine or for your back to hurt before scheduling an appointment with your doctor. Do it regularly, especially if you have any risk factor for kidney disease. This brings us to the next most dangerous bad habit for kidney health. Number 6. Ignoring the risk factors. Now, as I was saying, the scariest part of the big, impressive numbers about the worldwide kidney health problem is that 1 in 3 adults in the US is at risk for chronic kidney disease or CKD. And for being at risk, I mean suffering from a condition that's actively damaging the kidneys. I want to be extremely clear here, so forgive me if I'm repeating the same thing again. 1 in 3 adults in the US suffers from a condition. It may be diabetes, pre-diabetes, high blood pressure, high cholesterol, that could already be causing damage to their kidneys. Now, this kind of damage is really hard to repair, if it can be repaired at all. So, if you know anyone with a risk factor for kidney disease like high blood pressure, heart disease, diabetes, smoking, or even being 65 years old or more, send them this video via email, via the share button below, or even via WhatsApp. You can help them a lot. And if this includes you, don't worry, you are not alone in this, and there are things you can do to stop the progression of the disease and maybe even to get some kidney function back. To do this, you need to know and avoid the bad habits that can damage the kidneys. So let's see our next bad habit now. Number 5. Hitting the gym too hard. Turns out more can add up to less. While not exercising is dangerous, in some cases doing too much can be even worse. It's a big misconception that more is always better when it comes to exercising. I'm not just talking about the risk for injuries. Experts say that killing yourself on the treadmill for an hour a day isn't going to help you lose any weight or to improve your cardiovascular health. By doing this, you may just be stressing out your body more and causing your cortisol levels to rise and keep your body in an unhealthy condition. Cortisol is the stress hormone. Having too high levels for too much time can cause serious problems, and it also overworks the kidneys. Creatinine levels are higher in case of strenuous exercises, and this means that the kidneys are overworked too. Exercising too heavily can directly increase creatinine levels, indicating stress on the kidneys. High creatinine levels are the number one indicator of decreased kidney function. On the other hand, mild physical exercise is very health beneficial. It strengthens immunity, improves your mood, increases energy levels, helps sleeping, and also promotes blood circulation. Due to wastes and toxins accumulated in the blood, blood circulation of people suffering from kidney disease becomes poor, and this reduces even more the bloodstream in the kidneys. A better blood circulation is the basic for kidneys to get enough nutrition and oxygen from blood. So mild but regular exercise will give your kidneys a chance to improve. Yes, we should all be active and do an hour of moderate exercise 3 to 5 times a week. Number 4. Not sleeping enough. Not getting enough sleep on a regular basis can have nightmarish effects on our kidney health. Blurry eyes and gaping wounds aren't the only things that can happen when your body needs more sleep. A large study shown that people who slept 5 hours or less a night had a 65% greater risk of rapid decline in kidney function compared with people sleeping 7 to 8 hours a night. Yes, losing too much sleep can cause a lot more damage than a groggy morning. And while the correlation between lack of sleep and kidney disease has been proven, the reason why the damage is so severe is still unclear. More researches are needed, but even directly studying the effects of lack of sleep proven to be dangerous, since sleep deprivation is actually a torture method, and enforcing it on humans is not ethical. Researchers think that the body's natural rhythms, or so-called circadian clock, might also play a role. The kidney is timed to work differently during the night than during the day because the demands on the body are different. Seems like our kidneys need to sleep too. Number 3, drinking too much alcohol. Alcohol can be a poison if not taken in moderation. Recent studies say that people who consume regularly 3 or more drinks per day are at higher risk for liver damage, high blood pressure, heart disease, and even various cancers, including those of the liver and mouth. Alcohol-correlated risks are not a news, but you may not know how dangerous drinking too much can be for your kidneys. The kidneys are hard at work on any given day in a healthy person, but the kidneys of a heavy drinker work overtime. People who maintain this kind of drinking habit are at double the risk for developing kidney disease compared to the general population, including moderate drinkers. Drinking too much is exceptionally bad for the renal system, since in order to do their job properly, the kidneys need a certain rate of blood flowing into them. A liver that is damaged by alcohol abuse cannot properly regulate the blood that the kidneys receive, and even drinking too much just one time can be dangerous. Binge drinking causes a person's blood alcohol content to rise to dangerous levels, which in turn causes the kidneys to lose their function so much. The term for this is acute kidney injury. This is a condition whereby the kidneys are unable to stop dangerous levels of toxins from accumulating in the blood. Acute kidney failure as the result of alcoholism can develop in a matter of days or even hours. If untreated or if alcohol consumption continues, it can be fatal. Full recovery is possible, but there is the risk that the kidneys will be damaged beyond repair. Yes, drinking too much can be dangerous for the kidneys, even if it's one time only, so always drink in moderation. Number 2, using painkillers. When they're not taken properly, long-term habitual use can cause more problems than it solves. Using drugs like ibuprofen or aspirin for arthritis or muscle pain can, over time, increase your risk for ulcers, gastrointestinal bleeding, high blood pressure, and heart attacks. Painkillers may also be addictive, since they make you feel good. You may want to keep on taking them, turning them into a habit or addiction before you know it. And if this wasn't enough, there are studies proving a direct correlation between the regular use of NSAIDs like ibuprofen and aspirin to kidney disease. And the number one, the absolutely worst bad habit for your kidney health and overall health is eating too much sugar. Sugar can cause weight gain, diabetes, high blood pressure, inflammation, and consequently, kidney disease. Overindulging in eating sugary foods should be considered the number one bad habit for kidney health. What's worse is that sugar can cause a real addiction with effects similar to those of some street drugs. More in about this in the next video here.